Hello and welcome back to the channel. This is Abhinav. In this video, we are going to talk about the problem add strings of Geek Code August. Fine. So this is the week 2, second means of 9th of August problem. So what is given here? Here it is given that there are two string, which is integer string. It means a non-negative integer string, num1 and num2. So you have to add both the strings in a particular means a decimal order, means how you add decimal number to integer. You have to add these two integer strings and you have to output the answer also in a string. But here it is already written that you do not have to use any built-in function, or you don't have to use you don't have to convert the string to a particular integer to the corresponding integer, and then the problem will be very easy. But here you have to do this problem without converting into an integer. So let's say, I have written the code here. So first of all, let's move towards the whiteboard where we will first of all discuss the logic behind the problem. So fine. So I hope you are my whiteboard is visible. So in this whiteboard, first of all, let's say that number 1 string is s1. Here it is given num1, I will take s1 and s2, okay? Okay, and the length of the both the string, let's say, is L1 and L2, fine? This is the length of the string, and this is the, these are the both strings, fine? So first of all, we have to make both the strings length equal. So we have to make both the string, let's say the string s1 is 7, sorry, here I have making some problem, just a second. Okay, fine. So now it's okay. Okay, so let's say the first string is 7, 7, 3 and 5, okay, and another string is 86. I have just taken the random values. So this is the string. So to add both the strings, we have to take here like 7, 35 plus 86. Okay, we have to do this. So what we have to do is we have to make the string s2 also a 3-digit number, means a string of length 3, by adding 0 here, so that we can add it in a good manner. So yes, you can do it without making the both the string length equal, but in my logic, I am first making the length of both the strings equal, fine. So this is what I have done. So for that, I have written a code. You can see my code here. First of all, I have made that if L1 is written in L2, means if the length of string L1 is written in L2, then I have added 0 in string num2. And then increase the length of the string. And same for if L2 is written in L1, then I have made 0 add to the num1 string. Fine. Now what I have doing? Now what I am doing? I am doing. Let's move towards the whiteboard again. So what I am doing here? I am picking up the last character of the string one by one. For example, here now this string is 086. So I am getting first of all the last character from here 5, here 6. And then I am converting this character to an integer with the help of the ascii value. Like if let's say integer n, so n is equal to ho jayega, sorry, so n is equal to 5, because it is a character, and minus the ascii value of 0, the ascii value of 0, and this will result in 5. I hope you know this, okay, because here it is the ascii value of 5 minus ascii value of 0, which is 5. So like this, here I have taken a is equal to 5. I have taken two variables. One is a for the character of this, and for b is equal to 6. Now I am adding both the numbers. Also, I am taking a c is equal to 1, which is a carry. So for starting, carry is equal to 0. When we add, we take carry, no? Like this, and 6 plus 5 is 11. So 1 is here and 1 is carry. So I am taking the carry variable as c, and which is initially it is 0. Fine. So what I am done here, I am first of all, we will add all the numbers. So carry is 0, here the carry is 0, a is 5, b is 6. So 5 plus 6 plus 0, it is answer 11. So because 11 is greater than 10, so I have to, if 11 is equal to or less than 9. If 11 is equal to less than, then we will simply write 9 here, or we will simply add a 9 to the string, to the required string. But here it is 11, so we will add 1 to the required string, means we will add 5 plus 6 plus 0 minus 10. Okay, and we will give 1, means we will give the value of carry C variable 1, because carry is now 1 and we have to print here 1. So the value of this here is 1 and the carry is also 1. So like this I am doing the whole code. So let's move toward the code. Okay, so fine. So here let's say okay, now the length of both the string are equal, means L1. So what I am doing, that I am making a reverse loop from L1 minus 1 to 0, and one by one I am taking both the digits from both the strings A and B. Now I am and the variable C, which is initially 0, you can see here, which is initially 0. So if A plus B plus C is less than equal to 9, then we then the carry is 0, because we are just adding the number, the required output to the answer. And if it is greater than 9, means it is 10, this 11, then we will give carry a 1, because if 11, then 1 is the answer and 1 is the carry. So I am storing the answer here and give the carry to 1. Okay, and then I am printing here, then I am adding the ch here to the new string which we have to return. Fine. Here I have make another condition for, like for example, let's take an example of it here. But I have repeated the condition here for outside the loop, which is this, because let's take an example. Let's say here it is not 0, here it is 6, okay, here it is 6. So on adding, here it is 6, so on adding here the value will be 12, 1 and 14. So when we add, so here the carry will get 1 when we execute these numbers. Okay, so the value of the CS will be 4, and we will add the 4 to the required string, and carry will be 1. The carry will be 1. In the previous case, here the answer should be 8, so there should be no carry. Carry should be 0, then there will be no effect. But here the carry is 1, so we have to check the conditions once again out, because here the loop is completed. Here the loop is completed. This is the zeroth index of the string. So now the loop will be ended. But we have to once again check that if the carry, this is the value of the carry is 1, then we have to again add a 1 to the required, to the output string here. Okay, that is what I am doing. I am checking the once again if C is not equal to 0, means if C is equal to 1, then I am adding the 1 to the required string, and then I am returning the string. So you can see here my code, which is successfully executed. Okay, accepted, it is accepted. So thank you for watching the video. I hope you like it. So for Coursera solutions, for Coursera solutions, for lead code, for ad coder, for geek solution, please subscribe my channel. If you like the solution, hit a like button and comment below that it is useful. Join our Telegram channel for post contest discussions and for various discussions on